Hi, I'm Carly, and welcome back to MHN Season 6. And this is School Announcements, where I'm going to be giving you all of the latest news on MHS and fill you in on what you'd be missing during the daily announcements every week. Attention athletes, you might be eligible for a varsity letter jacket. If you've played 4 or more years of the same sport or have 5+ varsity certificates, you are eligible. Please contact Mr. Bolio for more details. It's time to order yearbooks. Yearbook orders will be done through Jostens this year. You can find the link to order through the MHS Daily Announcement link. Each yearbook is $70.
Hello, my lovely MHN sports viewers. I'm Aiden.
And I'm Sean, and this is MHS Sports.
The boys' varsity soccer team had a thrilling 3-1 win over the Bromfield boys' varsity soccer team. Goal scored by Henry Bourgeois, Daniel Corcoran, and Sean Roach.
The girls' varsity soccer team had an exhilarating 5-2 victory against Hudson, where Allie Roach scored a hat-trick. The golf team recently lost to AMSA, but with a great spirit.
The girls' field hockey team tied 3-3 against Bromfield on senior night,
with Haven Esterbrook scoring a hat-trick.
The Maynard cross-country team came up with a victory against AMSA in their last meet.
Welcome back to the Writer's Corner. I'm your host, Michaela Carey, and I'm here to showcase your talents in writing, so let's get started!
This first submission is a scary one, titled Twisted Love by Agna Portis. The drawing is also by her. As I enter the train, it is mostly empty aside from a group of teens being temptuous on one end of the train. I sit on the opposite side. Those teens are already on my to-do list, so I'd rather avoid any contact until the time is right. The girl that looks to be the youngest of the group is staring at me as if she's deducing I'm going to be doing something to them. She should follow her guts and get out while she can. When I arrived at the theater, I chose the least famous movie that there was and waited until we were at least 30 minutes into the movie. Then I proceeded to lock the doors. There were no security around since there were no more than 20 people in there, and 6 of them were those loud, annoying, and irritating teens. Good. I didn't want to have to go look for them in this big city. I have to leave as soon as I'm done here. I take the surgical saw in my bag, plug it into the wall, and start the real show. The final submission for this week's episode is another excerpt from If, submitted by Mr. Ogden. If you can dream and not make your dreams master, if you can think and not make your thoughts aim, if you can meet with triumph and disaster, and treat those two imposters just the same. If you can bear to hear the truth you've spoken, twisted by knaves to make a trap for fools, or watch the things you gave your life to broken, and stoop and build them up with worn-out tools. Come back next time to hear another excerpt from one of Mr. Ogden's favorite poems, and remember, if you have something you'd like me to read, please send it to my email, which will be at the end of this video. See you next time!
Welcome back to Living Not in the Kitchen. In this week's episode, we'll be making
edible cookie dough.
Let's get started.
First thing you're gonna do is get 1 cup of flour, and since we're eating this raw, you're gonna microwave it for 1 minute to kill any bacteria. In a mixing bowl, you're gonna add 1/2 cup of softened butter, 1/2 cup of brown sugar, 3 tablespoons of white sugar. Then go ahead and cream those together.
Add 1 teaspoon of vanilla extract,
1/2 teaspoon of salt, and then add the heat-treated flour.
Go ahead and mix those together.
Then you're gonna add in 1.5 tablespoons of milk.
And mix again.
Then go ahead and add in your desired amount of chocolate chips. We're adding 1/2 cup. Then go ahead and mix.
Should we taste it?
I think we should.
So I thought it was all right, but
it kind of just tastes like butter, if I'm being honest.
Butter and sugar.
Butter and sugar, which it basically is. It just doesn't really taste like your average cookie dough.
I'm gonna rate it
6 out of 10.
I'm gonna rate it a 5 out of 10.
You're definitely gonna wanna tune in for our next episode of Living That in the Kitchen because it's gonna be amazing.
Thanks for watching Living That in the Kitchen. Now on to the next segment.
Hi guys, I'm Emily and welcome back to another episode of Fashion Mania. The Billboard Music Awards aired on October 14th, and today we're going to take a look at some of the fashion from the award show. First, we're going to start off with one of my favorite singers, Billie Eilish. Billie won the awards for Best Female Artist, Billboard 200 Album, and Best New Artist. She wore a green floral matching blouse and pant combo from Gucci that she paired with a matching hat and mask. As always, her outfit is very loose and conservative. I like how even though the fit of her outfits are always the same, she tries to switch it up and keep it interesting with the patterns and colors. From far away, this outfit kind of looks camouflage though, and like she's gonna go take a trip into the jungle or something. So because of that, I think I'm gonna give it a 7 out of 10. Next, we're gonna look at Post Malone. He won 9 awards at the show, including Best Male Artist and Best Rap Album. He wore an all-black outfit, including a turtleneck and knee-length skirt, and also paired it with black Doc Martens. To be honest, I'm kind of torn between this look because the fringe on the leather jacket gives me like cowboy vibes, but then the skirt and high socks reminds me of like a kilt and it seems like he should be playing bagpipes or something. But I also like it because he didn't just wear a suit like every other male artist. He stepped out of his comfort zone and like embraced his femininity with the skirt, which I love. I think I'm gonna give it a 6.5 out of 10 because it still does confuse me, but I like how he wore the skirt. And lastly, let's take a look at Lizzo's outfit. She won Billboard's award for Top Song Sales Artist and was nominated for awards such as Best Female Artist. She wore a one-shoulder dress with the word vote written multiple times across it and paired it with a sleek ponytail. I like this outfit. I like how she made a statement and was using her outfit to show that people have a voice and they should vote. I mean, we all know how important this election was, so I like how she took that into account in her outfit for the award show. I'm gonna give this look an 8.5 out of 10. All right, that's it for another episode of Fashion Mania. Thanks for tuning in and see you next time.
Unsolved.
Unsolved indeed. Thank you for tuning in. Next week, we'll probably find a ghost.
I mean, it's possible.
Maybe.
We'll try.
Hi. Hello, my fellow Americans, and I live nearby. And I heard that you two were the best of the best to investigate my ghost issue in my humble abode. Please help. It's very scary. And I have a difficult time going. Tonight.
Obama, yes, we'd be happy to help. Just fax us your address.
Sadly, and I cannot be there to greet you, Lucas, and happy Halloween. And don't worry, I will pay you dearly for this. You'll get the bag and make that right.
I'll get the supplies, okay? We gotta have the ghost vacuum.
Hopefully we'll get into the Halloween spirit thanks to this spooky payroll from Obama.
Yeah,
are we getting paid?
Better pay, maybe. It's Obama.
Spooky.
Yeah, I mean, it's... Yeah, for Obama, you know.
Yeah, he really decorates. Very nice. Check out his sleeping arrangements.
Okay. Sure. All right. Off to see Obama's bed. Since I'm going upstairs to investigate, I'm gonna use this Charlie got us this ghost detector thing. I kinda wanna try it out, but I feel like it's not gonna work just because he's not very adept.
So this is what Obama eats? Saltines? Just saltines pierced with 13 holes in rows of 3 and 2? Plain saltines? You're rich and you eat this. Wow. Let's see if the fridge is stocked.
I got a popcorn ball.
I got a fudge bar.
I got a pack of gum.
Are you looking at this?
I got a rock.
Let's dine.
You want to try the Snickers? That's a dog.
I'm a dog, John. Give me a break.
Are you a dog? I thought you were more of like a ghost. Are you the ghost of a dog?
Yes, a poltergeist. Now let's teach you two boys the spirit of Halloween! www.history.com/topics/Halloween says that Halloween evolved from the ancient Celtic holiday, but they've barely scratched the surface. It all started with the birth of Frank, last name in Stein. And that's the spirit of Halloween.
Thank you for a wonderful evening.
This was quite nice.
Goodbye, good night, and happy Halloween!
Forgot my shoes.
Charlie, whatever, Obama will send you.
That was fun.
Yeah, it was cool.
Hopefully it wasn't a figment of our imagination.
Nah, it was totally real.
Yeah, let's get out of here.
Alright.
Truth be told, they never got paid because my house, it wasn't for mine.
I'm trying to put you in the worst mood. I be one cleaner than your church shoes. I really want to just to hurt you.